All right, to watch this video for Monday, July 9th. Pretty short list because we're coming out of a low-volume holiday week. The SPY did kind of break to the upside out of this range I've been talking about. Here is what I'll be watching on Monday. DEST held support in that 550 area and really kind of took off to the upside on Friday. You can see the big volume there and held up pretty well. So I want to watch that for a continuation. It's coming out of support, so I like it. JONE. Had this big pop back here, gave it all back over the next few days, and then volume again on Friday, and you can see the big pop there. So kind of like it over Friday's high, we'll see. That is a low-priced oil and gas play, so we're going to keep our eyes on those. I've got one other that I'm going to show you in a little bit that's on the list. DFBG had the gap up and then closed near its highs. Did make one call on this on Friday, and we're going to be watching it again on Monday with that strong close. PTIE. Had this gap down, and it kind of ran that day, and then we had a nice pop on Thursday. Friday was an inside day, so kind of like it over Friday's high, 255-ish. That might knock down this next catalyst of 275 and maybe get up into the gap over 283. Pretty good candlestick setup there. EKSO, nice looking chart. You had a huge move back here, lower high here, lower high here. Kind of had trouble with $2 here, really, and here too, here. Here and then it's trying to kind of break through now. On Thursday it hit 209, on Friday a high of 202.9, basically 203. Like it over Friday's high, might just break out one of these days over two, so we'll see. XBIO is very strong on Friday, closing well off its highs though. There's the intraday, so it held up for most of the day before giving some back at the end of the day. I'm gonna watch that one. ATOS. Little extra volume on Friday and closing pretty strong. We'll see if we get a follow through today there. And then TGC is that other low priced oil and gas play that was kind of with all of them that were running real hard. If oil and gas gets a pop again on Monday, you know, this one had a move from 90 cents all the way to over 240 in the course of two sessions, and then came back all the way to 97, but it's at that 8-day moving average. So the whole dollar might come into play. So anyway, if oil and gas gets moving, I definitely like this TGC for a low-risk setup. And I'm going to leave it at that. I don't have much more because I meant to make this video on Saturday morning and I ended up injuring myself because I wanted to give everybody 2 days' notice that our July 4th sale ends on Sunday, which is today. Since I didn't get the video done, I've been laid up most of the weekend. We'll get into that later. I'm going to go ahead and just leave the sale up for a few more days, maybe the middle of the week. So click down below if you want to check out our July 4th sale on our trading course and on our chat room. Also down below is a link to our free webinars, and there's some good content there. I'm going to leave it at that. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, and we'll see everybody on Monday.